Journalism is the first rough draft of history, the saying goes. I'm SE Cupp. Welcome to Unfiltered from Home. As journalists, we're there on the front lines, documenting history as it unfolds. That record is a rough draft. It's based on the facts we know at the time, within the context of the time. And that rough draft will invariably be updated as more information and context come. But the rough draft of history shouldn't be an alternate draft of history. And right now, right-wing media isn't doing journalism, it's doing fan fiction. It's been over a month since the November presidential election, and despite myriad lawsuits, there's no evidence, I'll repeat, no evidence, that the election was rigged or fraudulent or corrupted or stolen. Election officials, judges, state lawmakers, many of whom identify as Republicans, have all concluded against tremendous pressure from Trump himself that the election was sound and that Joe Biden is the legitimate winner. And yet the number of Republicans who believe that Trump is the legitimate winner and that the election was stolen is staggering. In several recent polls, the vast majority of Republicans indicate they believe the election was rigged or illegitimate. In one survey, 66% said Trump should never concede. Never. Like I said, these beliefs fly in the face of evidence and facts. These are, let's be clear, merely feelings. And facts don't care about your feelings. But you know who does? Right-wing news outlets like Fox, OAN, Newsmax, and others. They seem to care increasingly more about the feelings of their viewers and increasingly less about the facts. Now that makes what they're doing something other than journalism. You could call it propaganda. You might call it infotainment. You could call it fantasy, but you can't call it journalism. Now that these outlets have perpetuated baseless conspiracy theories and they've promoted Trump's paranoid delusions as facts or just as bad possibilities, that's distorted the idea of what's real and what's just wishful thinking. If a family member or a friend or a colleague went around saying things that were demonstrably untrue, unfounded, without evidence, in fact, contradictory to evidence that existed, we'd say they were detached from reality. We might even try to get them help. But when someone goes on a cable news show and does just that, with the imprimatur of a news organization behind them, and is joined by countless others who are reaffirming the untrue idea and painting themselves as political victims and their detractors as the real liars, what was once crazy talk is now seen by many as a cause. In some cases, one worth dying for. Let me repeat that. One worth dying for. This week, the Arizona Republican Party's official Twitter account asked if Trump voters were willing to give up their lives to help overturn the election results. Were they willing to die to make something that is true untrue? That is the impact of how successfully and dangerously much of right-wing news has abandoned journalism for activism. The fan fiction at Fox Primetime, Newsmax, other outlets that they've embraced, that might feel good to their viewers. And look, if Fox stops doing it, Trump supporters will have other places to get it. But if that's what they want, to go somewhere that feeds their conspiratorial political appetites for pro-Trump, anti-science, anti-reality, whatever, they can have it. We all need hobbies, and some of us love to escape from reality. I get it. But here's the rule. Wherever they go to find that, they can't call that place journalism. Journalists have an obligation to the facts as they exist, not as we want them to. Journalists have an obligation to question power, including in the White House. And journalists have an obligation to tell people what they need to hear, not what they want to hear. Sound good? Okay, that's it for me. I'll see you next week.